What's up guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, my name is Ray Gan and this is for ScarletMiata. Now this is the 100th video that I will be shooting for my Scarlet, and this just happens to be the second year modification update video. See, it's been 2 years of ownership, and in the second year I've continued my quest to make Scarlet even much better than she already is. So I'm going to share with you an update of all the modifications I've done in the second year. So let's get right on to the video. First of all guys, I'd like to express my gratitude and thanks to all of you for subscribing to my channel and for continuing to support and like my videos for my Scarlet, my Miata right here, and also my car review videos. You see, it's been 2 years of ownership already, and in that 2 year period I've racked up 11,000 kilometers. I know it's not that much, but Scarlet is not a daily driver. She is more of a weekend warrior for me. And in the second year, I've continued my quest in modifying her. Now, the second year didn't have as much modifications as I had in the first year, primarily because, well, I didn't really want to go overboard when it came to modifications. I didn't want it to look so gaudy or so, you know, over the top. You know, that has never been my intention when it comes to modifying my MX5. First up, the second year started with me continuing my quest for that perfect suspension ride and handling for Scarlet, particularly the elimination of that excessive body roll which all stock 4th generation MX5 Miatas have. And I was able to upgrade my coilovers and put in the front strut brace in the first year, but the body roll was still noticeably there. So what I've done for the second year was I put in a set of Cusco front and rear anti-sway bars, and these are non-adjustable fixed sway bars, but I believe that Cusco was able to dial in and tune these sway bars, these aftermarket sway bars, very well for elimination of that body roll without really, you know, losing that feel and the control of the car. And I was quite right when it came to that, because when these sway bars were installed, the Miata, my MX5 Scarlet, lost pretty much a big amount of that body roll, and now I could really control her through the corners, through the twisties, and I was able to prove that very well in a lot of my past long drives through the mountains. The next modification that I did is not really a modification where I added something, rather this time around I removed something. If you notice my rear bumper, it no longer sports the Skyactiv and MX5 emblems right here. I shaved them off when my Scarlet was hit on the rear by a van, just causing just a scratch, didn't really damage the bumper, but I'm kind of anal when it comes to these kinds of scratches and stuff. So I had this whole rear bumper resprayed, and during that entire respraying process I had the emblems removed. The thing that I didn't anticipate though was I didn't realize that the MX5 badge and the Skyactiv badge would have some pins underneath, hence there were some holes on the rear bumper. So aside from just respraying the bumper flat out, I had to get some putty and seal those holes first before the bumper was resprayed. So with that deletion of the emblems, I believe that Scarlet now sports a cleaner, sleeker look in the rear with just the Mazda emblem right here in the center, but there's no more badging in terms of MX5 or Skyactiv. Now some people wouldn't like that, some people would prefer to keep their badges, but personally in my own taste, I would rather have a cleaner, sleeker look for my MX5. The next modification I've had for Scarlet in the second year is this kit for Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. This is a convenience modification rather than a performance modification, and I must say that it is really just about convenience. You now have your Waze right on the screen instead of just looking on your cell phone, and you've got your Spotify as well and your Google commands, which you could do right here inside the infotainment system. The problem here though is that sometimes it would it would just conk out on me. It would just zap out, and sometimes it would just be confused when it comes to navigation. So it's not really the most perfect system out there. And for the price I paid, I'm not really too keen on this modification. The next thing I did in the second year for Scarlett, which is kind of like a major modification by itself, is this Craven Speed short throw shifter and aluminum shift plate. Well, I have to admit, the primary reason why I got this short throw shifter is not for performance. I got it because of the looks. I mean, just check it out. It is a beauty. I love how the aluminum plate gives it a very sleek, classic sports car look to it. And the shift knob from Craven Speed is also quite decent as well. So I love how it is just so beautiful to look at. It looks so mechanical, looks so functional. In terms of use, yes, the shifter has shortened my shifting distances by around 30%. That's what the Craven Speed website advertises, and I believe that it has shortened the shifting distance by that much. But in terms of usability, after a while I got used to it, but at first it was a little bit notchy, a little bit tough to find the right gears and all. But after a while you get used to it, and now I'm shifting it as if it's like the stock shifter that came with my MX5 Miata. And now we come to the final modification I've done in my second year of ownership of my MX5, and this is my most major modification that I've done ever since I've bought my car, and that would be these 17-inch wheels from Advan Racing. These are RZ2s in gloss black finish with a silver ring. And I also got new tires as well. Now these tires are GT Radial Champiro SX2 tires. These are semi-track, semi-road and track tires. Now the size is 215/45 R17. So these are a little bit chunkier than the stock Bridgestones that you can find in an MX5. Now for the wheel design itself, I chose these wheels because they are closer in terms of looks to the stock wheels of the MX5. Because as I mentioned in my previous video, I love the look of the stock wheels. I didn't really want to change it. I love these stock wheels, but what I hated the most was the offset. You see, the offset for the stock wheels was a plus 45, and that meant that with my car lowered on coilovers, the wheels were really tucked into the fender, and they kind of look smaller than they really are. Now, these Advan Racing RZ2s have an offset of plus 38. And at plus 38, it's the same offset as the ones found, the wheels found on the 30th anniversary MX5. It's the same offset found in the MX5 Cup cars that are being sold in the US. So at plus 38, the fender line and the wheel are already aligned to each other. And I love the stance of my Scarlett with these wheels right now. It looks more premium and more expensive than it really is, and it kind of looks like a small supercar in a way, at least in my opinion, in my eyes. So I love how these Advan Racing RZ2s totally completed the exterior look of my MX5. Now, I didn't want to go for the stock lug nuts, which are just small tiny silver lug nuts. Instead, I bought a set of work wheels anodized aluminum red lug nuts right here. These cost me a pretty penny, around $150 for the whole set, but I believe that they made the wheels pop out more given the fact that Scarlett is red, and now I have red lug nuts as well, which ties the whole look together. So will I change my stock wheels to aftermarket wheels again in the future? Or, you know, if I've given the choice, definitely yes. Although I love the design of the stock wheels, I hate the offset. And I hate that the fact that it's only 7 inches. These are 7.5 inches in terms of width. So they gave me more traction. They gave me a surer footing on the road as well. So I will definitely go aftermarket when it comes to my wheels and tires. So there you go, guys. Those were the five modifications I've done for Scarlett in her second year with me. Well, they're not that much, but they are pretty major given that the wheels and tires didn't really, you know, come cheap. But what's in store for Scarlett moving forward on my third year of ownership? Well, for one thing, looking at her now, I am quite happy already with her looks. I'm quite happy with the way she stands. I'm looking at the wheels, the tires, the way my carbon fiber spoiler just, you know, ties everything up. I'm really, really happy with how she looks now. So in terms of aesthetic modification, I prefer to keep it like this. Simple, tastefully done, not over the top. So it looks like this is gonna be how Scarlett would look like moving forward. In terms of performance, however, well, I am already in my third year this year, and that means that my engine warranty would pretty much expire at the end of the third year. That means that I could now be more open towards some engine modifications. I've gotten some suggestions for supercharging it or even doing an engine swap, but I don't believe I'll go that radical, that too far to the left side. Instead, what I'm thinking more of is probably getting a tune, probably getting some headers. I don't know. You know, these things are all up in the air, but still, my MX5 Scarlett is still under warranty, so I don't think I'll be touching anything in the engine department until after the third year. I'm also tempted to do some modifications in my electronics, my audio system, maybe my speakers, but once again, I don't really want to blow up my warranty within the third year. So maybe towards the latter part of this third year, I might think about going for a better audio setup, because honestly, the base model MX5 with its six speakers, it doesn't really sound that good in terms of audio quality. So maybe some better speakers are in order moving forward in the future. So since I can't really touch the engine and the electronics, I guess the look of Scarlett, the modifications I've done to her in terms of her interior, her comfort, convenience, and her aesthetic looks has already stopped. My mission to improve on Scarlett has already reached a temporary stop at this point, because I already find her perfect when it comes to my taste and my driving style. So what's in store for this channel moving forward? Well, definitely I'll have some more car reviews. I'll still upload some videos of my road trips and all that. So if you haven't subscribed yet to my channel, please subscribe to my channel. I promise you that this will be worth your while, and you'd enjoy watching videos about sports cars and cars in general here in the beautiful tropics of the Philippines. Once again, guys, thank you so much for the support that you've given me in my channel and all the love that you've given me from all over the world. I really, really appreciate it. And thank you for making this amateur vlogger blossom and improve a little bit in terms of what I'm doing for you guys. Anyway, I will see you again in the next video. Bye-bye.